Guys,
the guards seem pleased. Clever Scruff sticking with us. I can hold that bag for you. Leave them alone. They're one of us now. Yeah, one of us. And we all share bags and things.
Oh, don't take my bag, please. Leave my bag.
The stranger wanted Ember's attention, being careful not to speak too loudly. You should get away from here while you still can. You can't trust the birds. I've heard there's another campfire in the marsh. Well, that's where I'm going if I can find a way down.
So it seems to be some kind of machine you like, right? Some kind of... this is ghost. Maybe they're one of the guard. Oh no, where are they?
The travelers had disappeared.
Oh no.
The campfire remained. The ashes were still warm. Bear tracks lay in the cinders.
Oh no. Did they get them?
The guard squawked. Stand back, don't come any closer.
Stop there.
Nothing down there. Go see the Forest King. He'll set you straight.
Sure, father.
Got your first feather, I see. Best prove yourself, Scruff.
It's very not nice.
Stand watch here. Promise you won't let anyone pass.
Oh, great. You're just gonna leave me. Okay, great. Thank you. Just come on down there. Forget about me.
Ember didn't like deceiving the birds.
Wow.
But what choice did they have? They couldn't rest in that place forever. They had to keep going. The Forlorn was not the same as the others. The Forlorn whispered softly, I know what I need, but I am not ready. I may never be ready. The future is yours, stranger, but mine is mine.
Something
else. Left the Forlorn with their thoughts. The time wasn't right, perhaps would never be.
Oh no. So you can't really rescue.
Ember uncovered a journal entry. Dusk brings the longest shadows. The lanthorn comforts me. Soft melodies from home. The wild things listen. Yellow eyes in graying trees. Ember hurried away from the birds. The mist hung close to Ember, hiding them. The Forest King seemed frightened. The birds cruel. Ember would rather risk turning forlorn than become like them. Ahead, there would be others to help, and maybe a way to move on. Seem distressed. I'm sure it's fine. They'll be okay. But it's been a while since. It's my fault. it quietly. No matter where I go, I always end up here. No matter where I go, always here.
Wait, let's go back and see what's in there right side. Oh, what is this?
Hidden away was a scrap of journal. There are memories here, bound in rock. I hear their voices echo in the ancient stone. I find footprints by the cinders, a makeshift camp. It looked like a map, but pieces were missing.
Okay.
The piece formed a new route. It was the same place as before, but how? An eerie scene, like a moment frozen in time. Ember found a scrap of journal. I heard them coming. The snap of a twig, a flutter of birds. A figure dashing through the undergrowth. Another like me?
I guess that's from the little friend. The red one, right? He seems to be trying to escape this place too. And he seems to be observing us.
Gradually, more of the map was revealed. A section of bridge had somehow been ripped from its foundations. The fog was so blinding, Ember was turned around.
Ah, I can't go. Okay.
It was like the map had been broken on purpose.
I bet he was.
The mist revealed a secret place. Was it hidden on purpose?
Well, look.
The stranger spoke. You know, part of me didn't want to be found. I said some things I shouldn't have, and now I'm lost. It's too late.
It's never too late, baby.
Held tightly in its hand was a red feather.
So you want to come get it? Okay. I forced you to get it. Ah, it's dead. Yes. I saw this at the start, remember? When the little things played it.
The statue spoke, just as it once moved the heart of the forlorn. The instrument you now hold has the power to move the world around you. Another before you took great effort to hide it deep within this riddle.
Oh no, was it a trap?
The lanthorn began to glow.
Okay, so I can connect with those things. Press Y. Oh, I see.
Stranger spoke. I said something, okay. And now I'm lost. But it's too late.
Okay, let's try to find a way to help him.
Hidden inside was the Wanderer's journal. Another face at last. A catcher of fish resting by a pond. We work together, silk and tar and aching fingers. My boat floats once more, though I almost wish to stay.
Also, is someone going to escape? Something like that.
There was one last place to reach on the map.
Yes. Can I reach it? Let's try to go through here first.
The fog was so blinding, Ember was turned around. Ember felt a great relief to be out of the mist.
So cute.
Didn't mind getting muddy. The slide was such fun.
That was adorable. Okay, so I can go back.
A sleeping pig. Trotters in the air. They looked happy.
What is this?
The plant looked like it could take a hand off, and it was in Ember's way.
Oh, look.
boot was giving off a sickly sweet smell. The plant looked like it could take a hand off, and it was in Ember's way.
Maybe if I keep feeding it, it will stop it sometime.
Ember chuckled. The dangerous plant was no match for a hungry piggy.
Oh, so adorable. Such a good little piggy. And wallow.
A hideous odor filled the air.
Okay. Oh no, what is that?
And suddenly, the reason was obvious. Inhaled a giant snort of air. Wait, what's that delicious smell? Ember shuffled nervously. Other embers fed me treats, but then stopped. You feed me now. In its belly. Surprising, a little sparky, but tingly in belly. But what I want is something more fruity. The pig would eat anything. Ember just needed to find more. Was disgusting. Perhaps the pig would like it.
Could take it, but oh no, I don't want to take this.
Ember came upon another campfire lost in the wilderness. It looked long cold, but ready to be lit. The ghost said, "Speak." speak and I will listen.
Where did I?
This is the Hollow Marsh. Here hope was consumed before it could flourish. You must not lose hope, or you too will turn forlorn. Ember thought of those they loved, those they'd left behind.
There were
others lost along their journey. Find them and I will guide them. Down steps to your east, travel the path south, watching a pig grow unhappy, a forlorn lost hope.